friends, we will continue in this session further and understand as to what are the other control constructs available. In the previous video, you have seen the default control flow, and then you have seen how the if works, the if else works, the nested if else works, and also how the switch can be used to replace wherever there is a nested if else ladder. You have seen that. Today we would proceed further and understand the loops, the for loop, the while loop, the do while loop. These are the ones that we have to understand. Before understanding these loops, first thing what we have to understand is, why is it that these loops are provided in a programming language? If loops are not available in a programming language, is it really difficult for the programmer? First, let us explore that. Say, supposing my expectation is to write 5 times Sachin and 5 times Dhoni. That should be the output. That is my expected output. If that is the expected output, I can be writing it like this. Watch it. I can be writing it like this, wherein I would tell printf Sachin. Slash n is so that the next output comes on the next line. And then printf Dhoni. I can be telling like this. Obviously, in this case, only once Sachin and only once Dhoni is going to get printed. So, again I would tell printf Sachin, and then again I would tell printf Dhoni. You know, twice it would get printed. Similarly, printf Sachin and printf Dhoni. Thrice it is going to get printed. Similarly, I would tell printf Sachin and printf Dhoni. You know, 4 times it would be getting printed. Again, I would tell printf Sachin and it is printf Dhoni, in which case 5 times it would be getting printed. I know, while I was writing, you are getting frustrated, in the sense that, you know, if really anybody has to get frustrated, it should be me, because I am writing, you are only listening to it. Just imagine, if listening is only so frustrating, if you had to write it, how frustrating it would be. Only for 5 times if you feel frustrated, say supposing I want it 100 times, then how frustrating it would be. What I mean to say is, in programming, when you have to do something repetitively, then in order to avoid the frustration of doing things repetitively, you can make use of loops. Loops will do it repetitively for you. You do it only once and tell the loop to loop it as many times as you want. I know you may ask, sir, what are you telling, sir? What I am trying to tell you is, only write once printf Sachin, only write once printf Dhoni, and then tell the loop how many times it should be looping it. If you want that Sachin and Dhoni to get printed 5 times, you put a loop around that, such that the loop is going to loop it 5 times. If you want that to get printed 100 times, then put a loop such that the loop will loop those two statements 100 times. Through this, you can actually avoid your frustration. In fact, I would just complete this program for you. As I told, here we will have to tell clear screen. And then at the end, as you know, I will tell get CH. And then I would put it inside the main function. And as you know, I would also tell hash include stdio.h. All this in the previous video I have already discussed. Now, if this is the program, let us check as to what the output is going to be. Pay attention. The same program has been typed. And when I will execute this program, notice what happens. There are no errors and warnings. When I'll execute, as per our expectation, we have got the output. Sachin Dhoni, Sachin Dhoni, Sachin Dhoni, Sachin Dhoni. As per our expectation, we have got the output. So now, but then, you know, we have got the output, no doubt about it. But it was quite frustrating to write this program, you know. So I will rewrite this program using loops. And you would notice it that you can get the same output without much of a frustration. You would be able to notice it. Pay attention. The same program, I would be writing it besides here for your reference. Wherein you can notice, I am going to write only once printf Sachin like this. Only once printf Sachin. And I would write only once printf Dhoni. Printf Dhoni. Only once I would be writing. If you want it to get printed 5 times, then you have to tell it like this, that initially let it loop, that is I is equal to 1 till I less than or equal to 5 I plus plus. This is how we have to tell. If you ask, sir, what is it that you have written, you tell me that you wanted to print it 5 times. If you want it to get printed 5 times, then I am telling, first start with the I value as 1, then I value 2, then I value 3, then I value 4, maximum up to 5 you should go. That is what I am telling here, that this is the initial condition, this is the final condition. And each time I value should keep on incrementing by 1. That is what I have told. And in C language it is expected that these 3 things you should specify like this, and also put the statements that you want to loop, you know, inside the flower brackets. Now what is going to happen, sir, if you will ask? What is going to happen is this. When the I value is 1, it will execute once. It will loop back. Don't think after printing Dhoni control comes out. It won't come out because these 2 statements you have put it inside a loop. So it is going to loop back. Again it will execute. It is going to loop back, again execute, loop back, again execute. How many times will this happen, sir? If you tell, up to I becoming 5, it is going to happen. In other words, this loop is going to loop 5 times. But then I have to complete the program. As I have told in the beginning, I will put clear screen. At the end, I will put get CH. And also I have used a variable I, so I will have to declare that variable I. Not only that, as normal, I would be placing it inside the main function. And then, as normal, I will also tell hash include stdio.h. Now, if I will execute this program, I would be getting the same output as whatever previously I have got, but I think all of you would agree that this time when I wrote the program, it was not frustrating, because actually only once I wrote Sachin and Dhoni and I put it inside a loop, and for the loop I have told it to loop 5 times. That is what is the benefit of loops. Loops are there in a programming language not to frustrate us, rather to prevent us from frustration. I know in the first semester, wherein you are probably not understood loops correctly, you always used to feel that why this loop and all that, but now I think you realize without loops, our life as programmers would have become miserable. Anyway, let us see as to how the output is going to appear. Pay attention. The same program has been typed. Notice, when I will compile, no issues. When I will execute, as per our expectation, we have got the same output, Sachin Dhoni, same output. In fact, the advantage of writing the program through loops is that if I say have to execute it, or if I have to loop it 10 times, then I can do it very easily. I'll get back to the program. I just have to tell from I is equal to 1 up to 10. And now if I would compile it, no issues. When I'll execute it, you can see 10 times I have got Sachin and Dhoni. In other words, what as a student you have to understand is that loops are there to perform the task repetitively. So if you in your project have one task which has to be performed repetitively, then there are two ways of achieving it. You only write that task continuously, which will be frustrating, or write that once and put it inside the loop. For the loop, you should tell three things. The initial condition you have to tell, the final condition when it has to stop, that you have to tell, and the incrementation pattern you have to tell. Sometimes you want the I value to increment by 1. Sometimes your project may demand the I value to increment by 2. Sometimes the I value may have to increment by 5 each time. So that incrementation pattern you have to tell. Provided these three things you tell, your task is going to get repeated as many times as you expect. Going ahead, you would understand it even better. You can just quickly copy this example. Be quick. Copy this example. All right, so I would be proceeding further. If in case you feel that the time given is insufficient, you can always pause and copy, as I have told. The point is that in C language, we have three types of loops. One is the for loop, which we have just noticed. The other one is the while loop. One more called as the do while loop. Unnecessarily, students get confused with these three types of loops. Understand one thing, be it a for loop, be it a while loop, be it a do while loop, always you will have to have these three conditions in all the three: initial, final, and incrementation pattern. You have to specify, irrespective of the type of loop, you have to specify this. Now I'm going to do the same example using the other two types of loops as well. That is going to give you an idea and also remove the fear, if at all it is there, from the back of your mind regarding the loops. The fear would go off. Keep noticing it. Now, my job is to demonstrate the three loops, that is the for loop, the while loop, and the do while loop. Of course, I have already demonstrated the for loop. Now I should be demonstrating the while and the do while loop. Pay attention. I would first write the task, you know, that is whatever is the task that I am writing it. This is the task. Printf Sachin. This is the task. And then also printf Dhoni. Say this is the task. I would demonstrate all the three types of loops. That is what I have told. So again, I would just write the task here, printf Sachin, and then it is printf Dhoni. I would just again write it here, that is printf Sachin, and then printf Dhoni. Now say, I want it to repeat 5 times. The repetition can be achieved through for loop or while loop or do while loop. But I told you three things we have to specify. First is initialization, initial condition. I am telling here, initially let the value of I be 1. And then final condition, I has to be less than or maximum equal to 5, not more than that. Incrementation pattern I have to tell, means whether the I value each time should increment by 1 or increment by 2, that I have to tell. I will tell, let each time I increment by 1. And then if it is a for loop, I mean, you just have to tell for like this and put your task within the loop. This is something which you had already understood. Now let us take the case of a while loop. Now in case of the while loop, even here initialization, whatever here you are noticing I equal to 1, that I have to tell here also I equal to 1. Initialization is required. Next, the final condition. Here, whatever I less than or equal to 5, that I will tell it in the while loop as while I less than or equal to 5. And then you may tell, sir, incrementation pattern, that I will tell it here, I plus plus. This is the beginning, this is the closure of the while loop. So the point is that be it the for loop or be it the while loop, initialization, the final condition and the incrementation pattern, we will have to tell it. Only thing is, in the for loop we will tell it in the single line, whereas in the while loop we are going to tell it at different lines. Some of you may tell, sir, there is a do while loop as well. How to do it, sir? You may ask. Here also same thing, that first I will tell I equal to 1. Next I will tell do, and here I plus plus. At the end, you know, I will tell while, and that condition I will tell, I less than or equal to 5, that condition I would tell. Sir, why do we have three types of loops, sir? For loop, while loop, do while loop. Why three types of loops, sir? You may feel, why three types of loops? I would be clarifying it as and when we progress in our programming sessions, I would speak about it. But first, in today's lecture, you had to understand that be it the for loop or be it the while loop or be it the do while loop, always the three things, initial condition, final condition, incrementation pattern, has to be told. The difference is that where you will tell it, that is always the difference. In case of the for loop, everything in a single line we tell. In case of the while loop, in different lines we tell. In the do while also, on different lines we tell it. Of course, I would just complete it for your reference. The for loop version, you know, at the beginning as normal I will tell clear screen, and at the end I will as normal tell get ch, and also I will have to declare the variable I. Here also, in the beginning I would tell clear screen, at the end I will tell get ch, and I will also have to declare the variable I. Similarly here, in the beginning clear screen, at the end it is get ch, and I will also have to declare the variable I. And then as normal, you know that I will have to tell here as void main, and also hash include stdio.h. This is a program which already previously we had done. Here also I would tell void main, and then I will tell hash include stdio.h. Here also it is void main. I would put it inside this, and then I would tell hash include stdio.h. This is an example in which I have demonstrated how the same task can be repetitively done using different types of loops. Already the for loop version I have demonstrated in the previous example. Hence, now I am going to demonstrate the while loop example. Look at the display. The while loop has been used. As you can see, initialization is here. The final condition where it has to stop when the I value becomes 5, that is here. And each time the incrementation pattern I plus plus, that is here. Now notice it. When I would compile, we have no issues, and when I'll execute, as per our expectation, we have got the answer. I hope it is completely clear. In fact, here also I can get back to the program, and if in case I tell let I begin from 1, let maximum I go up to 10, if I will tell, then if I would again compile, no issues. When I will execute, you can see 10 times I have got Sachin and Dhoni. I hope all of you have been able to understand the while loop part of it. Next, it is the do while that I will have to explain. In the do while part, you can be noticing that this is the same program, you know, the do while part of it. You can see initialization is here, incrementation pattern is here, the condition checking part is here. Now when I will execute it, again no issues in the compilation. During execution we have got the output. In fact, if I would get back to the program and then make that as say 10, and now again if I would be compiling it, no issues, when I'll execute 10 times as per our expectation, we have got the output. I hope this example has given you an idea that loops are there to avoid frustration for the programmers. However, different loops demand different syntax, but all the loops demand the same thing: initial condition, final condition, and the incrementation pattern. This is what they would demand. But at different places you have to give. I know this question may be there in your mind. Sir, when for only can do the looping, why do we require while loop? Or okay, for and while are there, okay, why do we require do while loop? Really, are three types of loops necessary? Because we see that they are all producing same output. These could be some of the doubts in your mind, which I can't clarify in the very second lecture. You have to wait to realize in which circumstances in your project, which type of loops you have to use. To know that, it would take certainly some more time. I would certainly clarify it during the course. I would be clarifying it. But to start off with, I hope you have been able to understand the syntax related to the three types of loops. I hope it is clear. You can quickly copy it in your notes as well. Okay, so I would be proceeding further to explain something more related to the loops part. Normally within the loop, if our project requires, we sometimes use break, we sometimes use continue. What is the use of this, sir? You may ask. What is the use of that? How to use it? All that I am now going to tell you. I would take for loop as an example, and I'm going to clarify it for you. Pay attention. I would, you know, erase whatever previously I have written. You can apply the continue as well as you can apply break on any of the three types of loops. But I am just going to take for loop as an example. All of you know, this is the way that for loop I have written. Now directly I would be writing, that is for I is equal to 1 up to I becoming 5, I plus plus inside this. If in case I tell printf and then I tell Sachin, and then if I would tell printf and then if I would tell say Dhoni, you know, if in case I execute this, all of you know, if in case I execute this, Sachin, Dhoni, again Sachin, Dhoni, again Sachin, Dhoni, like that 5 times it would print Sachin and Dhoni. All of you know that. Say supposing I will put a break here. If you recollect, we had previously used break in the switch statement, in the switch control construct. I had used it. I had told you that break will take the control out of the switch. That is what I had told. Here also same thing. Break will take the control out of the loop. In fact, you can use break only in these two things. You can either use it in the switch or you can use it inside the loops. Any of the loops you can be using it. You can't use the break with if else. You can't be using it. In the sense that break always takes breaks the control out of the switch and the control goes out, or if you use it in a loop, break will break the control out of the loop and the control goes out. So if you ask me, okay sir, how does it work? If you ask me, first time, you know, when the control comes in, the I value would be 1. It would print Sachin. Soon after Sachin, you have told of break. Because you have told break, control will break and come out of the loop. Hence, the output that you can expect for this is Sachin gets printed. You may tell, sir, but I had told the loop to loop 5 times, sir. You may tell, correct, you had told the loop to loop 5 times, but you only told break also, due to which control will break and come out. In this example, I am not going to write the remaining part of the program. All of you know, here clear screen, here get ch, and then declaring I, and then putting it in the main function, and then writing hash include stdio.h. I think by now you have already understood it. So it'll be a waste of time if I now start writing complete programs. Rather than that, I would just write this much, and I hope you would be able to write the complete program yourself. But anyway, first let us check as to what the output of this is going to be. If you notice, the same program has been typed. As you can see in the display, there is a break. If I would compile it, one warning, we don't care, forget about it. If I would execute, as per our expectation, we have got Sachin as the answer. I hope what the break does, you have been able to understand. So you can just quickly copy this program. And also you can copy the output as Sachin. That is going to be the output for this one. Be quick. Alright, so there's one more thing which we can use within a loop, that is the continue. What would continue do? You know what break does? It takes the control out of the loop, whereas what continue does, notice that instead of break, in case I tell here as continue. Please understand, this word continue itself is telling so clearly as to what it does. Continue does not let the statements below that to get executed. Rather, Sachin will get printed. After that, continue. Continue means it goes back for looping. It skips whatever is there below it. So for the first time, Sachin gets printed. You have told continue means it goes back for looping. Again prints Sachin. Again continue. So again it prints Sachin. Again continue. So again it prints Sachin. In other words, only Sachin would be getting printed 5 times, not even once Dhoni would be getting printed. In simple words, break will take the control out of the loop, whereas continue is going to take the control back to the beginning of the loop. Hence, in this case, our expected output is going to be Sachin, 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 Sachin 5 times. Let us see if really that is the output that we would be getting. As you can see, the break is there here. I would replace that break with, say, continue. If I would replace it with continue, and then if I would compile, one warning, that's okay, forget about it. And if I would execute, you can notice we have got Sachin. 5 times it has printed. In simple words, break takes the control out of the loop, whereas continue takes the control back to the beginning of the loop. When we use them in the projects, I have been telling you, at an appropriate time I will tell you. But what break does, what continue that does, that basic information has to be there with you, which is what I have clarified through this example. You can also copy this example. And also you can copy the output. You know, 5 times Sachin is going to get printed. That would be the output. Be quick. Alright, so you have been able to understand the for loop, the while loop, the do while loop, and within that, if you use break, what happens? If you use continue, what happens? You have been able to understand this much. It is good. But then I would also now mix up for, if, and break, and just see as to how it works. See if you can analyze the output of this. What I would tell here is that if in case the value of I becomes equal to 3, then you break. That is what I have told. And then as normal inside this, previously whatever I have told, printf Sachin, and then printf Dhoni, I would be writing as it is. Say this is our program. What would be the output of this program is the issue. Analyze it carefully. For the first time, I is 1. You only know for the first time I is 1. Certainly I is not equal to 3. So control won't break out. Rather, Sachin Dhoni gets printed. You know that. So, I should be getting the output as Sachin Dhoni. After this, again it loops back. When it loops back, remember the I value would become 2. But even then, it is not equal to 3. So, control won't break out because the second time I is 2. So, it comes here. Again it prints Sachin Dhoni. Again it prints. After which, next time when it loops, remember the I value would be 3. So, if I is 3, yes, because I is 3, control will break out. That time Sachin and Dhoni won't get printed. This is what is our expected output as per our understanding. Now let us see if the system is going to produce the same output or not. When I would compile, no issues. When I will execute this, as per our expectation, we have got the answer. Again, some of you might still be thinking that, sir, in the program, you have only told the program to loop 5 times. Internally, you are only telling to break as well. Why, sir? If you really wanted to break by only printing twice, then you could have told here print only twice. In the loop itself, you could have told. Why to in the loop tell loop 5 times and then here put a break such that it will break and come out quickly? I've been telling you that where we use all these things, in future you would come to know as and when I discuss the programming classes. But as of now, I just had to tell you as to how this piece of code works. I hope all of you have been able to understand it. You can also copy this example along with the output. Please be quick. So I hope in this session, whatever you have learnt, I think the loops are clear. Within the loops, we can also use break and continue. That is also clear. Break is going to take the control outside the loop, whereas continue is going to take the control back to the beginning of the loop. That is also clear. Where we actually use it going ahead, you would be able to understand. I hope now from the first two sessions, all of you have been able to understand as to the default control flow is sequential. If you want to make a choice, you can use if else. If you want to make a choice out of many options, then you can use nested if else, or what we call as the else if ladder. Or you can also, instead of the else if ladder, make use of the switch. This is what we learnt previously. And then if you have to do something repetitively in your project, then you can make use of any of the loops. And an option is provided that within the loop, you can prematurely exit the loop. You can prematurely come out of the loop using break. Or you can only execute a part of the loop, and the remaining part of the loop you can skip the execution using continue. This much is what you have been able to understand through these sessions. Thank you very much. We would continue the remaining in the next session.